Three, two, one.
Wake up in the morning feeling like P. Diddy. Grab my glasses, I'm out the door. I'm gonna hit this city. Before I leave, brush my teeth with a bottle of
water.
'Cause when I leave for the night, I ain't coming back. I'm talking pedicure on our toes, toes. Trying on all our clothes, clothes. Boys blowing up our phones, phones. Dropped up and playing our favorite CDs. Pulling up to the parties. Trying to get a little bit
dizzy.
Don't stop, make it pop. DJ blow my speakers up. Tonight I'ma fight till we see the sunlight. Tick-tock on the clock.
Hey Waylon, Mrs. Dole here. And I have something pretty important that I need to talk to you about. It's kind of a big deal. There's a big deadline, and all of next year hinges on it. Yes, you guessed it, it's scheduling. So we need a couple of things from you. The first thing we need is we need you to go online and enter your courses, 18 of them plus 3 alternates. The second thing we need is we need for you to complete the course request form, that colored piece of paper that you just got in your class meetings, and turn that into the guidance office to Mrs. Mulder. The third thing, if you will be a junior or a senior next year, if you are interested in attending the Tech Center, you have to scan that QR code. If you don't scan the QR code, we will never know that you ever wanted to attend the Tech Center. So enter your classes online, complete the form with your name on it, turn it into Mrs. Mulder, and then if you're a junior or senior, the Tech Center, you need to scan the QR code. The other thing you need to note is that there are 900 of you and there are only 4 of us. So while we love meeting and talking about and helping you plan for your future, it's going to take us a little bit to catch up. So that is not a reason to delay entering your classes online or turning in your sheet. We will meet with you. You only need to sign up once. Please don't email. It's just going to take us a little bit. The deadline for this task is January 19th. January 19th. Anytime after the 19th, Mrs. Mulder then has to hunt you down. And if that's the case, you will get last dibs on your favorite classes. And I hate to see that happen. So take care of business by January 19th. Thank you.
Hey guys, next week is Coaches versus Cancer Week, so we're going to give you a little rundown of the week. So you can either pay $10 for all the activities, or you can pay the individual price of what activity you want to go to.
On Monday, we have pancake breakfast, $5.
Tuesday is the staff versus students Powerball game, which is $3 separately.
On Wednesday, we have the staff versus students basketball game, which is $3 separately.
And then on Thursday is the variety show, which is $3 separately. So you need to buy these at lunch and sign up.
Hey guys! So the staff versus students basketball game is back, and it is going to be next week, Thursday, January 11th.
It's $10 to play, so sign up at lunch, and players will be chosen randomly. So go sign up!
Go students!
Hey Wildcats, Change Wars is back next week for Coaches versus Cancer. Rules are simple, change is positive, dollars are negative. Bring in your change to your third hours to increase your total amount. If you bring in dollars, you can choose to bomb other classes during your third hour to decrease their amount. The winning class with the most amount of money at the end is a treat. Let's bring in the change for a good cause.
Hey guys, next week is Coaches versus Cancer Week.
And it's January 8th through the 12th.
Our spirit days are Monday, pajama out.
Tuesday, Adam Sandler day.
Wednesday, jersey out.
Thursday, tie versus tie-dye.
Friday, purple up. Make sure to participate.
Hi, I'm here with Dawson and Michaela, and I'm going to ask them some questions for snow coming. First question, what is your favorite movie quote?
We'll need a bigger boat.
Okay.
That is the ugliest effing skirt I've ever seen in my life.
All right. Second question. What is the weirdest thing you've seen in somebody's home?
Lucas's mom cosplaying as Elle from Stranger Things.
A paper mache seagull hidden in the fridge.
Okay. Third question. What is one random fact you know?
Pigs can't look up.
Okay.
There are 293 ways to make change for a dollar.
Okay, fourth and final question. Why should we vote for you?
I'm the best Wallowitz.
Okay.
Because I'm the best theater kid. Ew, no. I don't like theater kids. It's okay. Just vote for me anyway.
All right.
birthday to
Britton Van Aker,
Madison Batrol,
and Aiden Rode.
Learning Lab is open today, 2:45 to 4 p.m. in the Media Center.
Lot Club is meeting today at 2:40 in room B205.
Wayland High School esports team is looking for Rocket League players of all different ranks and skills. We also have Mario Kart. We would love for you to come be part of the esports team. Esports meeting will be held on January 5th at 2:40 in D404.
Good morning, Wildcats. Today for lunch is
sweet and sour chicken and an egg roll. What's the joke of the day?
Why don't eggs tell jokes?
Because they'll crack each other up.
Good morning, Wayland Wildcats.
Let's get started with some sports results.
Boys varsity bowling beat Forest Hills Eastern in a comeback from behind win 16.5 to 13.5. The JV bowlers beat FHE 18-12.
Girls varsity bowling beat FHE 30-0.
Your varsity bowlers also bowled in several tournaments over the holiday break. The varsity boys play second in the Catholic Central Christmas Baker Game Tournament. Both boys and girls varsity placed right in the middle of the field at the Spectrum Lanes Tournament. Congratulations to Kyle Vanesse taking 9th and Izzy Botwinski taking 4th.
The Wayland wrestlers had a great night last night. Alexis Hozeska started the night off with a big win over an Allegan state-ranked opponent.
The varsity wrestling team defeated Allegan 50-25. Jody Bittner, Rex Emery, and Miles Nesbitt are just a few of the wrestler Wildcats with big pins last night.
In exhibition matches, Eli Weaver and Pepe Miguel Garcia each had standout wins.
Well done, Wildcats. Peace out.